Look, we talked about this beforehand. If you're Brian Kemp, you're not happy what took place here. But this also should be a rebuke to those legislators in Georgia who actually made this law. This is an utterly ridiculous law, and it's the kind of crap Republicans keep doing in the southern states to have to, of course, put in effect voter suppression.
Yes, I don't know where to begin, Roland. First off, I want to say and echo what you said about the Lawyers Committee. I want to echo the good work that they're doing, because there's no doubt that there's shenanigans being played across the country in elections. And you mentioned earlier in your remarks that you have a series of black Republicans who come across who deny voter suppression exists. Let me make it very clear, I'm not one of those people. I do recognize that there are some issues, particularly in North Carolina, which I just don't agree with, and it's horrible. But just going back to Georgia, my friend, you talk about how they are putting up barriers to voting. As you know, as I mentioned before, Georgia has a record amount of voter registration now than ever in the history of Georgia under the Republicans, Secretary of State. Again, I don't know Brian Kemp, not defending him, but I'm just pointing out the facts. Also, Georgia is one of only 13 states that has automatic voter registration. This is like the crown jewel that Democrats have been trying to pass across the country. And Georgia is one of the few states that has automatic registration so that you're automatically registered to vote, making it easier to vote when you go to the DMV. And so you're characterizing, you're cherry picking these incidences, trying to make it seem like, you know, Georgia in 2018 is Georgia of the Jim Crow era when Democrats actually stopped blacks from voting. But that's not what's taking place in Georgia. Going to the decision that was made today, it just came out, as you mentioned, it's about
Brandon,
40 pages.
Brandon.
Yeah, you want me to get, okay.
Brandon.
Yeah, where are we at?
Brandon.
Rolling.
This is the problem that I keep trying to explain to you Republicans.
Okay.
Which is a problem. You put barriers in place. Black people are going to leapfrog those barriers. But we shouldn't have to be leapfrogging the barriers. And so you're using the same argument Supreme Court Justice Roberts did when he said, oh, well, black voter turnout has dramatically changed, so we don't need Section 4 of the Voting Rights Act.
That's not the same argument.
The reason you have high black turnout is because of Section 4 and the Voting Rights Act.
So automatic registration is a barrier to black votes? Please explain that, Roland. You never talk about that. So automatic registration, which Democrats are pushing for nationwide, is somehow a barrier to black
votes?
Why
should Republicans?
Come on now.
Why should Republicans? Hold up. Why? Okay, Brandon.
Is that,
are Republicans pushing same day voter registration?
Jump over it or no? Are you going to respond to that one
point? No, I'm asking you a question.
Okay. Ignore my
question. I'm asking you a question. First of all, it's a good thing. My question is this here. Do you, as a Republican, do you support automatic voter registration and same day voter registration?
Yes and yes. Yes and yes.
Good. You're one of the few ones. Cleo.
Oh, yeah, you go over my
point. No, hold up. I got to go to Cleo. Cleo, go ahead.
Well, all I can say is I learned something today that I didn't know before. As you know, on your show, I've complained about us not anticipating voter repression because it happens. It's been happening for years. And I just met Dorian from the Lawyers Committee, and apparently working with Stacey Abrams, they've been dealing with this issue or trying to deflect the possibility of voter repression at least since 2004 or maybe... So that's really impressive for me to hear because, as I've said many times before, this is old news. They did it way back when George W. Bush and before that in terms of black people being repressed. But it's good to hear that Stacey Abrams is so focused that she worked on this issue years ago and has made, I think that might be part of why she's doing so well now. Like I said, before, her ground game in Georgia is one of the most powerful ones I've ever seen before. So this sister is quite brilliant and has great vision. So it's good to meet you, Dorian. It's good to hear about the work that you're doing.
Hey, folks, if you're looking for a hot new investment opportunity, I have two things I want you to think about, illegal marijuana and crowdfunding. Now, you just let that sink in for a second. Our friends at Transatlantic Real Estate have created a unique opportunity for everyday investors like you to get in the game. If you want to find out more, go to marijuanastock.org. That's marijuanastock.org to get in now. Now, back to your Roland Martin Unfiltered video.